Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Mystery of the Shroud of Turin. Chapter 1. The Sacred Trail. Detective Alan Carter's office, cluttered with case files and old maps, seemed like an unlikely starting point for an adventure that would lead him into the heart of Spain and the mysteries surrounding the Shroud of Turin. It all began with a letter, an ancient parchment sealed with a wax emblem that bore an uncanny resemblance to the symbols engraved on the shroud itself. As Alan carefully broke the seal, the air in the room seemed to shift, as if an unseen force had been unleashed. The letter, written in elegant script, spoke of a clandestine cathedral hidden within the Spanish mountains, tied to the enigma of the shroud. The detective's analytical mind sparked to life as he read the words penned by an anonymous sender, claiming knowledge of a conspiracy woven into the fabric of history. The trail started in Barcelona, a city pulsating with life yet hiding secrets within its labyrinthine streets. Alan enlisted the expertise of Evelyn Turner, an architect known for her passion for historical mysteries. Together, they embarked on a journey guided by cryptic symbols etched on ancient walls, leading them to an elusive sanctuary shrouded in centuries-old whispers. The first clue unfolded in the Gothic quarter, where narrow alleys intertwined like a web of shadows. Ancient buildings, their facades adorned with mysterious symbols, stood as silent witnesses to a history steeped in secrecy. Alan and Evelyn followed the symbols, each turn revealing a layer of the enigma they pursued. The detective's keen eyes caught glimpses of intricately carved patterns on stone facades, symbols that seemed to transcend time. Evelyn, with her architectural acumen, noted the subtle variations in each design, recognizing patterns that hinted at a hidden language woven into the city's very fabric. The trail led them to a forgotten courtyard, where an ancient fountain served as a silent sentinel. The symbols on its weathered surface resonated with those on the shroud, creating a bridge between the tangible and the mystical. Alan's fingers traced the engravings, and a connection sparked in his mind. A realization that Barcelona held the key to a secret buried for centuries. Their quest intensified as they ventured into the heart of the city, uncovering concealed entrances and deciphering the codes that guarded the path to the Spanish mountains. The detective and the architect moved through the city like modern-day alchemists, unraveling the mysteries encoded in stone, guided by an ancient force that seemed to urge them forward. As night fell over Barcelona, Alan and Evelyn found themselves standing before an ornate door, adorned with symbols that mirrored those on the shroud. The door swung open, revealing a passage that led into the depths of the city's ancient foundations. The air within resonated with a tangible energy, as if the past itself whispered secrets to those willing to listen. Their journey through the subterranean passages brought them closer to the heart of the conspiracy. Symbols on the walls transformed from mere decorations into a narrative, telling a story of a brotherhood sworn to protect the shroud from falling into the wrong hands. The detective and the architect, their senses attuned to the resonance of the symbols, felt the weight of history bearing down on them. As they emerged from the underground labyrinth, the streets of Barcelona held a new significance. Every corner, every facade seemed to speak of a hidden truth waiting to be unraveled. The detective and the architect, now bound by the invisible threads of the enigma, prepared to follow the sacred trail that would lead them into the heart of Spain, where a clandestine cathedral held the answers to the mysteries of the Shroud of Turin. Chapter 2: The Enigmatic Cathedral. The trail of symbols, now intertwined with the essence of Barcelona, guided Detective Alan Carter and architect Evelyn Turner into the majestic mountains of central Spain. Their journey, both physical and metaphysical, unfolded against the backdrop of ancient landscapes and enigmatic clues that beckoned them toward the clandestine cathedral linked to the Shroud of Turin. The winding roads through the Spanish countryside led them to a remote region where the mountains stood sentinel, their peaks obscured by mist. Hidden within this natural grandeur lay the entrance to the sacred sanctuary they sought. The duo, armed with the knowledge gleaned from Barcelona, approached the mountains with a reverence reserved for places touched by the divine. As they ascended, the air grew thinner, carrying with it a sense of anticipation. The symbols, etched on rocks and tree trunks, guided them through the labyrinth of the mountains, unraveling the secrets that had been guarded for centuries. The detective's analytical mind worked in harmony with Evelyn's intuitive understanding of ancient architecture, creating a synergy that transcended the boundaries of conventional investigation. Their journey culminated in the discovery of an entrance concealed within the rugged terrain. The door, adorned with symbols mirroring those on the shroud, yielded to their touch, revealing a passage that led into the heart of the mountains. As they descended into the subterranean realm, the atmosphere shifted, and an ethereal glow emanated from the walls, as if the very stones were infused with ancient wisdom. The clandestine cathedral, hidden beneath the Spanish mountains, unfolded before them like a sacred tapestry. Illuminated by the soft radiance of candles, the space echoed with a tranquility that contrasted sharply with the rugged exterior of the mountains. Stained glass windows depicted scenes that seemed to transcend earthly narratives, telling a story of a brotherhood sworn to protect the shroud and the enigmatic powers it held. Evelyn's eyes widened with wonder as she studied the architectural marvels within the cathedral. Columns adorned with symbols acted as conduits of spiritual energy, and the very stones seemed to vibrate with the echoes of centuries-old rituals. Alan, his detective instincts heightened, surveyed the sacred space, recognizing patterns in the design that hinted at a deeper connection to the Shroud of Turin. As they explored the hallowed chambers, the detective and the architect uncovered frescoes that illustrated the history of the clandestine brotherhood. Scenes of ancient rituals, guardians standing vigil, and the shroud itself unfolded like a visual chronicle. The detective's gaze lingered on depictions of the sacred artifact, each rendering revealing new insights into its mystical significance. In the heart of the cathedral, a chamber concealed behind a veiled curtain held a particular allure. As Alan and Evelyn approached, the air thickened with a sacred energy. The symbols on the curtain seemed to shimmer, inviting them to unveil the truth that lay beyond. With a gentle gesture, they parted the curtain, revealing a hidden alcove that cradled a replica of the Shroud of Turin. The replica, bathed in a soft light, mirrored the intricacies of the original. Alan's fingers traced the contours of the fabric, as if seeking a connection with the centuries that had woven their tales into its fibers. Evelyn, captivated by the artistry and symbolism, recognized that the replica was more than a mere copy. It was a conduit to the powers that permeated the clandestine cathedral. Their investigation took an unexpected turn as they discovered a concealed passageway leading to a subterranean library. Ancient texts, illuminated manuscripts, and scrolls written in languages long forgotten lined the shelves. The detective, drawn to the wealth of knowledge at his fingertips, began piecing together the historical tapestry that linked the Shroud to the clandestine brotherhood. As they delved into the texts, Alan and Evelyn unveiled a truth that extended beyond the tangible relic. The Shroud, it seemed, possessed qualities that transcended the boundaries of mortal comprehension. The clandestine brotherhood, guardians of this sacred knowledge, had dedicated centuries to understanding and protecting the relic's enigmatic powers. The revelation was interrupted by a distant echo footsteps approaching from the shadows of the cathedral. The detective and the architect, now armed with newfound insights, prepared to confront the custodians of the clandestine sanctuary. The journey into the heart of Spain had unveiled layers of the enigma, yet the conspiracy surrounding the Shroud of Turin remained veiled in mysteries that begged to be unraveled. Chapter 3: Symbols of Conspiracy. The clandestine cathedral, nestled within the Spanish mountains, echoed with the whispers of centuries. As Detective Alan Carter and architect Evelyn Turner delved deeper into its mysteries, they found themselves entangled in a web of symbols that seemed to transcend the confines of the physical world. The air within the sacred space pulsed with an energy that hinted at cosmic truths waiting to be unveiled. As the detective and the architect continued their exploration, they encountered a network of symbols intricately woven into the very fabric of the cathedral. Each corridor, each archway, bore markings that hinted at a deeper conspiracy surrounding the Shroud of Turin. Deciphering these symbols became paramount as they delved into the history of the clandestine brotherhood, realizing that their quest had unearthed not only a hidden sanctuary, but a conspiracy of cosmic proportions. The symbols, etched into the stones and murals, seemed to speak a language that transcended earthly comprehension. Evelyn's architectural insight and Alan's detective instincts melded seamlessly as they pieced together the intricate puzzle that adorned the cathedral's sacred walls. The duo found themselves immersed in a narrative that spoke of a cosmic connection between the Shroud and the clandestine brotherhood. The detective and the architect discovered a hidden chamber adorned with celestial symbols, celestial maps, and diagrams that hinted at a celestial connection. The stars, it seemed, held a key to the conspiracy. As they traced the constellations depicted on the cathedral ceiling, a revelation unfolded. The Shroud of Turin was not merely a relic, but a celestial artifact with the power to harness cosmic energies. Their investigation into the symbols led them to a realization that the shroud was a conduit, aligning with celestial events to unlock its true potential. The clandestine brotherhood, custodians of this knowledge, sought to protect the relic from falling into the hands of those who sought to exploit its cosmic powers for malevolent purposes. In their pursuit, Alan and Evelyn unearthed a hidden chamber dedicated to celestial studies. Ancient instruments, astrolabes, and celestial maps adorned the space, pointing to a profound connection between the shroud and cosmic alignments. The symbols, meticulously inscribed, told a tale of a brotherhood that had transcended the boundaries of time and space in their quest for enlightenment. The detective and the architect, guided by the symbols and cosmic revelations, sensed a malevolent force lurking in the shadows. It became evident that the conspiracy extended beyond the clandestine brotherhood. There were entities seeking to harness the celestial powers of the shroud for their nefarious purposes. The stakes were heightened as the duo realized that the very fabric of the universe was at play in their quest for truth. As they continued their exploration, Alan and Evelyn uncovered a library containing ancient manuscripts that spoke of cosmic rituals, celestial alignments, and the sacred geometry woven into the architecture of the cathedral. The symbols, when decoded, revealed a ritualistic pattern that involved the shroud, the celestial bodies, and the cathedral itself, a convergence of cosmic energies with the potential to reshape reality. The detective and the architect, armed with this newfound knowledge, confronted the custodians of the clandestine sanctuary. The conspiracy, it appeared, was a battle between cosmic forces, one seeking to protect the delicate balance, and the other attempting to wield the shroud as a tool for unimaginable power. In the heart of the cathedral, surrounded by symbols that bridged the earthly and celestial realms, Alan and Evelyn faced adversaries driven by a lust for otherworldly dominion. The symbols, once mere decorations, now pulsed with an intensity that mirrored the cosmic energies at play. The conspiracy, intricately woven into the symbols, had escalated into a cosmic battle for control over the shroud's celestial powers. As the detective and the architect confronted the malevolent force orchestrating the conspiracy, a celestial alignment unfolded above the cathedral. The very stars seemed to bear witness to the cosmic struggle within the sacred space. The fate of the Shroud of Turin, the clandestine brotherhood, and the cosmic conspiracy hung in the balance as Alan and Evelyn grappled with the forces seeking to exploit the relic's transcendental powers. The symbols, now charged with celestial energy, became a conduit for the cosmic drama unfolding within the cathedral's hallowed walls. Chapter 4, The Unveiling Conspiracy. The celestial alignment above the clandestine cathedral intensified as Detective Alan Carter and architect Evelyn Turner faced adversaries driven by a lust for otherworldly dominion. The symbols, pulsating with an intensity that mirrored the cosmic energies at play, seemed to transcend the earthly realm. The conspiracy, intricately woven into the symbols, had escalated into a cosmic battle for control over the shroud's celestial powers. As Alan and Evelyn confronted the malevolent force orchestrating the conspiracy, the very air within the sacred space thickened with an otherworldly energy. The adversaries, cloaked in shadows, revealed themselves to be entities tethered to the cosmic forces, seeking to exploit the relic's transcendental powers for their nefarious purposes. The celestial alignment cast an eerie glow upon the cathedral's hallowed walls as the detective and the architect prepared to face the cosmic conspiracy. The symbols, once mere decorations, became a conduit for the cosmic drama unfolding within the sacred space. The clandestine brotherhood, guardians of the Shroud's celestial secrets, stood alongside Alan and Evelyn, forming a fragile alliance against the malevolent entities threatening the delicate cosmic balance. The adversaries, possessing a dark understanding of the celestial energies, sought to harness the Shroud's powers to reshape reality itself. The symbols on the cathedral's walls pulsed in response to the impending cosmic clash, their intricate patterns reflecting the celestial dance above. Alan, with his detective instincts, recognized the adversary's intent to wield the Shroud as a tool for unimaginable power, transcending the boundaries of mortal comprehension. The battle unfolded amidst the celestial alignment, with Alan, Evelyn, and the clandestine brotherhood pitted against the malevolent entities. The symbols, charged with cosmic energy, became focal points for the clash of forces, a cosmic chessboard where each move resonated with the very fabric of the universe. As the adversaries unleashed otherworldly abilities, the cathedral's architecture responded in kind, creating a fusion of earthly and celestial energies. Evelyn, with her architectural insight, recognized that the Shroud itself was a key player in the cosmic drama. Its fabric, intricately woven with symbols that mirrored the celestial patterns, acted as a bridge between dimensions. The clandestine brotherhood, armed with their ancient knowledge, channeled their energies to protect the delicate cosmic balance, forming a barrier against the malevolent forces. The detective, with his analytical mind, deciphered the cosmic ritual unfolding within the cathedral. Each symbol, each gesture, held significance in the cosmic battle that transcended the earthly realm. The adversaries, fueled by their lust for power, sought to manipulate the celestial energies to bend reality to their will. As the clash of cosmic forces reached its zenith, the cathedral's very foundations seemed to quake with the intensity of the struggle. The symbols on the walls glowed with an ethereal brilliance, casting intricate patterns of light that danced in harmony with the celestial alignment. Alan and Evelyn, guided by the clandestine brotherhood, stood resilient against the onslaught, determined to protect the Shroud's celestial secrets from falling into the wrong hands. In a climactic moment, the celestial alignment reached its peak, and the Shroud itself began to resonate with an otherworldly energy. The fabric seemed to ripple, revealing glimpses of cosmic realms beyond mortal perception. The clandestine brotherhood, united in their purpose, channeled their energies to create a barrier that repelled the malevolent entities and protected the delicate cosmic balance. As the adversaries recoiled, defeated by the united front of the detective, the architect, and the clandestine brotherhood, the celestial alignment gradually waned. The symbols on the cathedral's walls dimmed, returning to their dormant state. The cosmic battle had reached its resolution, leaving behind an eerie calm within the sacred space. Alan, Evelyn, and the clandestine brotherhood stood amidst the aftermath of the cosmic clash, their collective efforts preserving the delicate equilibrium. The Shroud, now a silent witness to the celestial drama, hung in its revered place, its fabric vibrating with the residual energy of the cosmic alignment. As the cathedral's atmosphere settled, the clandestine brotherhood, grateful for the detective and architect's assistance, offered insights into the shroud's celestial powers. The symbols, once enigmatic decorations, now held a deeper significance, weaving a narrative of cosmic energies, celestial alignments, and the delicate balance that must be maintained to safeguard the relic's secrets. With the adversaries vanquished, the detective and the architect emerged from the clandestine cathedral, their quest for truth complete. The symbols, once conduits for cosmic forces, returned to their silent state, etched into the cathedral's walls as a testament to the cosmic conspiracy that had unfolded within its hallowed space. The celestial alignment, having served as the backdrop for a battle of cosmic proportions, faded into the tapestry of history, leaving behind the enigma of the Shroud of Turin, a relic that bridged the earthly and celestial realms, waiting for those daring enough to unveil its secrets.